Yes, sir, we promised you a great main event tonight.
Andre, the Giant.
WrestleMania.
Hulkamania is running wild. Yes.
My God, what a rock!
WWE Hall of Famer, Tony Atlas!
It's the Abraham Washington Show, starring Abraham Washington. Tonight, Abraham welcomes his guest, the general manager of ECW, Tiffany. And now,
Tony, get it. Oh, yeah. Oh, boy. Oh, yeah, that's right. Oh, man. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. Oh, you guys are wonderful. Thank you. Now, I would like to go ahead and welcome everyone out to the critically acclaimed Abraham Washington Show. And of course, I am your host, the most entertaining man in all of sports entertainment, Abraham Washington. Now, it seems as though we got some haters in the crowd tonight, huh? A whole arena full of haters, huh? But that's fine, it's okay, because I'm still a pimp, okay? Now, yeah, that's right, I said it, I ain't scared of nobody. Now tonight, we have a very huge show, and I'm gonna do something that I don't do very often, and that is stop running my mouth. Hey, Tony, don't be like them, that's not funny, okay? All right? You don't wanna be back in the unemployment line, do you? All right, get it together. Now, like I said, we have a very huge show for you this evening. So at this time, will you all please join me in welcoming the general manager of ECW. Give it up for Tiffany! Goodness gracious, girl, you are fine, huh? I'm not worried about catching no swine flu at this point because I think I just caught a case of jungle fever up in here, girl. You are smoking.
You are hot, Tiffany.
You agree, Tony? Yeah, she's hot. Oh, yeah. But Tiffany, in all seriousness, you're in the hot seat right now, considering the fact that there has been much criticism of you and your administration here at ECW, considering the fact that this past Sunday we had bragging rights and SmackDown versus Raw, but ECW had zero impact. What do you have to say for yourself about that?
Well, I would say that ECW had a tremendous impact at bragging rights. I mean, look at the members from Team Raw, Team SmackDown, from John Morrison to Kofi Kingston. They all had their first big break right here on ECW. And as far as next year goes, ECW will have an even bigger impact at bragging rights. I guarantee it.
You guarantee it. You guarantee it? Girl, this ain't the men's warehouse. We don't care about no guarantee. Huh? We don't need no suits. What we need are superstars. And speaking of superstars that got their start here and left, let's talk about Sheamus, huh? What about that jacked up Irish Ronald McDonald, huh? Where's he at? What's going on?
Well, Abe, I work under the premise that if you don't want to be here, I don't want you here. And Sheamus informed me this past week of his decision to leave. So I informed Sheamus that he could leave for good after having one last match tonight against Shelton Benjamin.
Well, all right, then I guess it's just one last question to ask.
Yep.
How's your arm, huh? How's the chicken wing doing? You doing okay? Is it healing well?
Thank you so much for asking. As a matter of fact, it's healing up really.
Excuse me, dear, but I've come out here to appeal to you one last time. I implore you, give me what I deserve. Please give me an ECW championship match.
Mr. Regal, you have asked me repeatedly, and my answer has not changed. No.
Madam, I am losing my temper. I demand that you—
Let me make myself clear. You are not getting an ECW championship match tonight. Perhaps you will never get another shot at the ECW championship. Thank you all for coming, and I hope you enjoy tonight's show.
I'm insatiable.
Gentlemen, that is all the time that we
what you see
have.
Is what you get.
Hey!
You can see the contempt in the eyes of William Regal. Regal absolutely livid upon hearing the news that he may never receive another ECW championship match. But we're just getting started, and well, on a brighter note, joining me right now at ringside is the newest member of the ECW broadcast team. His name is Byron Saxton. Byron, welcome to ECW.
Well, thank you very much, Josh. I couldn't imagine a bigger or better night to be here on ECW than the night where championship mist is almost in the air, because tonight, you know it, Christian defending the ECW championship against Yoshi Tatsu.
It is our main event tonight, and it's a result of what took place last week, a number one contenders match. It was Zack Ryder one-on-one with Yoshi Tatsu. And Yoshi Tatsu, well, he took full advantage, Byron, of this opportunity.
Yoshi Tatsu, the one that no one thought could, and he has, the Cinderella story of ECW coming true, winning that number one contender spot, which brings us to where we are tonight.
All right, now let's take a closer, in-depth look at the number one contender to the ECW title, Yoshi Tatsu. He's one of the most exhilarating and exciting young superstars on ECW.
Yoshi Tatsu has electrified the WWE universe, quickly becoming a fan favorite.
Thank you.
Well, there is no question about it. Yoshi Tatsu has the attention of everyone.
Look at the agility, the athletic ability of Yoshi Tatsu.
Wow.
Unbelievable. Whoa, are you karate kidding me? Wow. The sky may be the limit for Yoshi Tatsu.
Zack Ryder is that 21st century cop athlete.
The only good thing to come out of Long Island is Zack Ryder.
He's not afraid to be his confident self.
Woo, woo, woo.
These ladies want an original.
Call him. No. Look at me. I'm charismatic. I'm athletic. I'm good looking. And I've got a killer sense of style.
Be impressed with Zack Ryder.
Oh, Zack attack. Devastating.
You know it.
Falls. Now approaching the ring from Dublin, Ireland, weighing 272 pounds, Sheamus!
Byron, we found out last night that Sheamus is Raw's newest acquisition. The Celtic Warrior competing for the last time here on ECW, and Sheamus perhaps seeking retribution on his rival, Shelton Benjamin, and things escalated between these two superstars even further last week right here on ECW.
You know, it goes without saying that this rivalry has reached a fever pitch. And just to see Shelton Benjamin, to see how he has reacted over time, I have never seen this much intensity, this much disdain from Shelton Benjamin towards one man.
Shelton just couldn't take it any longer. And a fire and intensity inside of Benjamin. Shelton all over Sheamus last week. And standing by right now is our colleague Savannah with Shelton Benjamin.
Shelton, how does it feel knowing this is your last opportunity to face Sheamus here on ECW?
You know, a few weeks ago I had to listen to this guy basically call me out. He put me on blast by saying that my entire time in the WWE has been mediocre. And I had to sit at home and actually thought, you know what, maybe he's right. Maybe after 8 years in the WWE, I'm just wasting everyone's time. And I should just pack my things up and leave. But then I thought, hell no. Who is this guy? He has to attack me from behind? What does that make him? Huh? What does that make Sheamus? It makes him a coward. A coward who then goes on to hightail it to Raw as if he's done anything to impress anyone. Well, before Sheamus goes to Raw, I have a little parting gift. Tonight, Sheamus is gonna gain a newfound respect for the gold standard Shelton Benjamin.
Against a man who's got nothing to lose. Sheamus is gone after this. Sheamus is going to Raw, and now it's up to Shelton Benjamin to leave a lasting impression.
Well, Shelton would certainly like to send Sheamus to Monday Night Raw with a loss here on ECW.
Look at the stare down between these two. I mean, you can just feel the culmination of this rivalry.
I said it before, Sheamus has brought out an intensity inside of Shelton that we haven't seen in quite some time. And as Shelton said earlier, he's going to have a parting gift here tonight for the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus.
It all centers around one word, disrespect. Shelton felt he was disrespected by Sheamus, all his accolades, all his championships. You heard him, he said it. Sheamus called him mediocre at best. That's saying on the left. Whoa.
Benjamin looking everything but mediocre right here. And look at the athleticism of Shelton Benjamin. Benjamin is rolling over his rival right now. Can Benjamin continue? We'll find out when ECW returns.
Hello, I'm WWE superstar John Cena with a very important message for all of our fans. WWE superstars are professionally trained performers. The moves that we do in the ring take years of practice to perfect and do safely. I urge all of our fans, never try and copy what we do in the ring, at home or at school. Stay safe. Don't try this.
Welcome back to ECW. Let's see the look of agony on the face of Sheamus going one-on-one with Shelton Benjamin. This will be Sheamus' final match here on ECW as Sheamus is going over to Monday Night Raw. As a matter of fact, Sheamus debuted last night on Raw and looked very impressive.
Now you look at a match like this and you look at Shelton Benjamin, it's sort of like that kid that ruled the playground for the longest time. You know, then you got this new kid from another school who tries to push you out of your spot, which forces a guy like Shelton to step up his game, and that's exactly what you're seeing here right now.
Remember what our ECW general manager, Tiffany, said earlier. If you don't want to be here on ECW, then you don't have to. You can leave. But let me remind you, ECW is the place to see young, vibrant, aggressive superstars here in the WWE. In my opinion, ECW has the hungriest locker room in all of the WWE.
Yeah, and a slightly angry locker room as well. I mean, when Sheamus made that decision to go to Raw, he didn't make him a whole lot of friends around ECW.
And right now, Sheamus intent on dishing out punishment to his rival, Shelton Benjamin. Another look right here is Sheamus. Drives Shelton to the steel post.
And don't think, you know, we talked about Shelton trying to protect his playground, so to speak. Sheamus has got something to prove, too, because he wants to send a message to each and every superstar on Raw that is watching this match.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, Sheamus has flat out said that every other superstar is a stepping stone for Sheamus on his way to the top.
See the pain etched on the face of Shelton Benjamin as Sheamus cranks back with all his might. Power of Sheamus coming
out of the lateral press and
come on.
Just like that, all it takes is 3 seconds. Kind of wonder in the back of your mind, perhaps is Sheamus distracted by his new status on Raw? Is he fully focused on Shelton Benjamin?
I was wondering the same thing, but it appears that Sheamus is fully focused. You can see Sheamus continues to dish out the punishment. Another cover here on Shelton Benjamin. Hands clasped. It doesn't appear that Sheamus is taking Shelton, who's a former Intercontinental Tag Team and United States Champion, lightly right now.
And how do you call that mediocre? I don't get that. Benjamin, known as indeed one of the best pure athletes, not just here, but all the WWE.
There's no doubt that Benjamin is a game breaker.
Sheamus again, utilizing that strength, utilizing that power, pressure on the neck. Looks like he might be trying to cut off that air supply.
That's a sound strategy here by the Celtic Warrior. Keep the gold standard Shelton Benjamin off of his feet.
Two men have just been a thorn in each other's sides week after week.
you see the speed.
Nice counter by Shelton Benjamin, but he's still out of it.
This
could be the turning point of this contest. See, Sheamus, just another clubbing shot. Benjamin not backing down at all.
Each man digging deep, trying to get the better of the other. Neither one wants to step down. Neither one wants to give up.
For Shelton, it's all about sending Sheamus to Raw with a loss here on ECW. The pace quickening.
Benjamin knows so many eyes are watching, the eyes of the ECW locker room, watching to see if the gold standard can come true.
That unique offense of Shelton. Sheamus counters. Shelton counters. Benjamin's got him.
Man.
Byron, we got a poll for Shelton Benjamin in this match. I mean, Sheamus, it's sad to see him go, but Sheamus is leaving ECW.
He's no longer here. You said it. I mean, Shelton Benjamin is representing the land of extreme right now.
Pump kick from the Celtic Warrior. This may do it. Sheamus into the cover. And he got it.
And your winner is...
That glare, that intense glare from the Celtic Warrior Sheamus now belongs on Raw, but look at this. Shelton so close, just about had Sheamus. The Celtic Warrior down. That's so close. But Sheamus took advantage. And that there followed up by the pump kick to the side of the head to the temple of the gold standard. Sheamus victorious over Shelton Benjamin.
Well, Shelton Benjamin has nothing to be ashamed of, and he will continue remain the gold standard in ECW. Folks, don't forget, still to come tonight, the charismatic captain of charisma versus the superstar success story, ECW championship on the line as Christian defends against Yoshi Tatsu.
Come out to the country, we'll have a few laughs.
Oh, relax, Sean. It's WWE Survivor Series. We're D-Generation X. We're indestructible.
We're not that indestructible.
Calm down. It's a movie set.
Yeah, just a harmless prop.
You're right. Sorry. I guess not everybody survives.
WWE Survivor Series.
You don't know how happy I am to be on ECW. It gives me an excuse to go shopping for outfits every single week. I've been going to the gym, working out every day. Look, I'm in the best shape I've ever been in my life. Oh my God, I went to the mall the other day and I bought this sexy new dress. No puedo decirte en palabras. And this girl recognized me. She's like, are you Rosa Mendez? And I'm like, yeah. And she bought the same new dress as me. All these people started asking me for autographs and... Oh, what is it you want to ask me?
I just said hello.
Well, of course you're gonna say hello to me because I'm the new ECW diva and...
Sis.
Leave.
I have a proposition that's gonna end this once and for all. So I wanted to tell you, so you can in turn pass it on to your little friend the Hurricane, to meet me in the ring next week.
Well, he'll be there.
Well, we are just getting started here on ECW. Josh Matthews alongside ECW's newest broadcast member, Byron Saxton. Byron, we got a big one coming up still.
Just getting started, but the goosebumps are building, because just knowing we are just moments away, inching closer to that main event, Yoshi, Tatsu, and Christian.
Big night still to come, but everyone is still talking about the events that took place this past Sunday at Bragging Rights. Which show would earn the ultimate kudos of Bragging Rights?
This is a 7-on-7 SmackDown versus Raw Bragging Rights match set for one fall.
This is the deciding match to decide which show will bring home the Bragging Rights trophy.
It all comes down to this.
This is so emotional. This is about being the best of the best.
It's all about pride. It's all about brand supremacy.
And whichever team wins, they're going to be bragging, and rightfully so.
God, a spear! 500-pound spear!
This is vintage Bragging Rights.
Come on, Big Show! Yes, come on, Kofi! Big Show just chokeslammed his own teammate. We had this thing won!
Triple H just knocked out. I believe Big Show just became Ross Benedict Arnold.
And now Jericho.
No, not like, come on now. Not
Jericho
like this.
Win.
Come on, Kofi.
A win is a win. Superior show. They prove it right here on Bragging Rights.
We will absolutely never hear the end of this.
Ladies and gentlemen, joining me now is the ECW champion, Christian. Christian, you have said very good things about your opponent tonight, Yoshi Tatsu. How do you feel about facing him for your title?
Well, it's like I said before, to me, Yoshi is the most deserving of any person to be the number one contender for the ECW Championship. Because unlike some other people around here,
William Regal,
he actually went out and earned some wins. See, Yoshi's the type of superstar that gets me excited about the future of ECW. And he's going to be a champion in years to come. Just not tonight. And you see, I've been mentoring Yoshi as of late. I've taken him under my wing. And tonight, right here in front of all of my peeps in Rochester, New York, Yoshi's gonna learn the most important lesson any young talent can learn: how to cope with defeat.
Every day I train.
Thousands of hours of practice.
Injuries can happen at any time.
My kneecap just kind of blew over to the side of my leg.
I've torn the pectoral muscle completely off my shoulder.
I've had surgery 5 times in my left knee.
The tendon was torn off the bone, couldn't hardly lift my leg anymore.
With every move I make,
my body,
my life is on the line.
Don't risk yours. Please, don't try this.
Championship intact. Can he come through? proverbial Cinderella story of ECW. But now is the time for Yoshi Tatsu to shake off the butterflies and to step up for what undoubtedly is the most important match of his career.
Yoshi Tatsu has been blazing a trail ever since debuting here on ECW. And now Yoshi is the number one contender. Right now, Yoshi Tatsu has an opportunity to become the brand new ECW champion.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the ECW Championship. Announcing first, the challenger from Tokyo, Japan, weighing 220 pounds, Yoshi Tatsu! And now his opponent from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing 227 pounds. He is your ECW champion, Christian!
That's what it's all about.
I can't imagine the butterflies, the nervousness that Yoshi Tatsu must be feeling right now. This is Yoshi's first ever opportunity at the ECW Championship.
You know, another thing to notice here, look at the tights of Yoshi Tatsu, gold tights. Is that sort of maybe a psychological message to the champion?
We'll have to wait and see. Yoshi, of course, earned his opportunity to compete for the ECW Championship by defeating Zack Ryder last week. And now Yoshi must contend with the current and reigning ECW champion, Christian.
And don't forget the relationship these two have outside of the ring.
Sure, Christian's been like a mentor to Yoshi, helping him learn the English language. And they've actually been tag team partners in the past as well.
Christian talked about it earlier on tonight, not only confident that he would take care of business here tonight, he also basically said, he said Yoshi Tatsu would have to learn how to cope with defeat.
We're going to find out if that's true right now. What if Christian has to learn to cope with defeat?
Touché.
Christian did say that Yoshi is most deserving and will one day be a champion, just not today.
You just feel the hush over the crowd here of anticipation, knowing that this is a big time feel, main event here on ECW.
Christian's been in this situation before. Christian, the former Intercontinental World Tag Team Champion. Those are two different championships, Intercontinental and World Tag Team Championship.
Indeed, yes. And of course, if Yoshi Tatsu were to win here tonight, this would be his first championship, period.
Oh! Christian remains one step ahead of Yoshi Tatsu. Springboard sunset flip. Yoshi down, does he? Oh!
Man. Christian looking like he wants to end this thing early.
Why not?
Blame him. Yoshi Tatsu's right there with him.
Cover here by Yoshi. Do we have a new? No. Yoshi backslide here. Christian stacked up. Two dozen. Wow.
I am really surprised by Yoshi Tatsu. I mean, he is bringing it. He knows what's on the line. He knows how high the stakes are.
There is nothing more important than the ECW Championship. It's the goal of every single superstar here in the ECW locker room. Yoshi, schoolboy! Tremendous opportunity here for Yoshi Tatsu. Yoshi's building momentum. Can Yoshi Tatsu shock the WWE Universe? We're gonna find out when ECW returns.
returned.
It's been a long time since my peeps have seen me.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Captain Charisma himself is back.
Welcome to the Peep Show.
Here comes Christian.
Whoa!
Since returning, Christian has set the world ablaze.
Christian soaring through the air and connecting.
Welcome back to ECW. This is our main event for the ECW Championship. The champion Christian one-on-one with Yoshitatsu.
You know, before the break, I think we saw the strategy of Yoshitatsu loud and clear, sort of going for that shock and awe effect, trying to get several close near pinfalls. Oh, man. Do you hear that?
Heard it. Yoshitatsu certainly felt it. Christian building momentum, not so fast! The quick striking ability of Yoshitatsu.
This could be the opening Yoshi needs. He's gonna fly! Crash and burn. They always say high risk, high reward.
Well, don't take your eyes off of Christian right now!
Oh, and there's the reward.
A veteran maneuver there by Christian. It was Yoshi who misses right here. You can see, oh, the ankle, the knee there. And Christian was able to capitalize right there. I have to wonder, perhaps Yoshi tweaked his knee, his ankle there, and going for that high-risk maneuver.
Well, that comes with the territory, but can you blame him?
Lateral press by Christian. Yoshi down.
Can you blame Yoshitatsu for going for that high risk? Again, he knows what's on the line. He knows how important the stakes are. We're talking about the ECW Championship.
I've also talked in the past about the determination of Yoshitatsu. Oh, the desire by Yoshi. Crossbody. Christian's down. Does he have him?
Yoshi trying to complete that dream story, coming to our country with nothing but a dream. Nothing but a dream, and now one match away from accomplishing that dream. Yoshi knows his family, his friends back home are watching. Back in Tokyo, Japan, looking on wherever they can, hoping that their fellow countryman can achieve the dream, can accomplish the impossible.
See Christian just staying one step ahead of Yoshi. Cover, leg is hooked.
It seems like we see Yoshitatsu try to fight back, and we see these counters by Christian. Those words ring true, the words he stated before this match, that Yoshi, a young superstar in ECW, will have to learn how to cope with defeat.
We're gonna learn just how tough Yoshitatsu is right here, right now, going one-on-one with Christian for the ECW Championship.
If Yoshitatsu wants to become ECW champion, he's gonna have to learn how to dig deep for that special something. But Christian has other intentions.
Yoshi had Christian well scouted there.
Or are we seeing it?
Yeah.
Yoshitatsu once again looking for that high risk, looking to capitalize.
Spinning wheel kick from the top rope. Do we have a new champion? Oh no, did he get it?
How close can you get? Yoshitatsu a split second away. I think almost Christian might be kind of shocked that Yoshitatsu is coming as hard as he still is. That quick strike ability, those kicks.
The buzzsaw-like kicks from Yoshi. Yoshitatsu building momentum. Oh!
Yoshi with the quickness.
Oh! Roaring elbow! Yoshi cover! New champion! New champion!
Oh! Yoshitatsu's got to be asking himself, what is it going to take?
What do I have to do?
The WWE Universe is on the edge of their seats. Christian going for the kill switch.
Can he get it hooked?
Kill switch it. No. Oh! It's a victory right there for Yoshi to counter the kill switch.
I am so impressed with Yoshi Tatsu. But I think we know what's coming here.
Christian remaining in control right here.
Oh!
A hard shot from the ECW champion.
Christian. Playing the proverbial role of the mentor. Trying to finish off his mentee.
We've seen this in the past, and the ECW champion, Christian, got caught. Jackknife. Yoshi rolls through, and he got it.
Did he get him? He got
Wow. Yoshi Tatsu was an eyelash away from becoming the ECW champion.
Yoshi Tatsu is shocked. You can see the look on his face, shocked that he still has not been able to put away the ECW champion.
Oh, I don't think Yoshi's half as shocked as Christian is.
Watch out!
Cover here! This will do it, Christian!
Wow! My gosh!
That's the desire and determination of Yoshi Tatsu.
That's desire and passion it takes to be a champion. You're seeing it from the champion. You're seeing it from the challenger. Which man will win it all? Yoshi going back to those kicks. That's what brought him to the dance. That's what brought him to this moment.
Christian, springboard, sunset flip. Yoshi rolls through. Wow!
Connection.
What a kick! Christian's down.
Oh, gosh! Still not enough. Not enough.
I'm wondering, and I'm sure Yoshi Tatsu has to be wondering, what is it gonna take to defeat Christian?
Yoshi Tatsu has thrown everything he can at the champion.
Christian had that kick telegraphed. Kill switch engaged. Fulcrum kick out of the corner. Oh.
Christian, perhaps thinking this match was in hand. Perhaps thinking he's got Yoshi Tatsu right where he wants him.
Christian is feeling it right here. Kill switch. Kill switch!
And he connects this time.
Three opportunities. This time Christian connects, shoots the half, and is victorious.
And your winner, and still the ECW champion, Christian!
The ECW champion, Christian, the man with more experience. Christian's been in this situation before, and it was perhaps that experience that allowed Christian to defeat Yoshi Tatsu here in a very competitive match. You have to take your hat off to Yoshi Tatsu.
Yeah, let me just go on record right now and say, with all the hype, with all the anticipation, this match delivered and more. It looks like, again, that mentor-mentee relationship.
You have to go back to what happened. Oh, what's this?
What? Why?
Kozlov and Jackson.
You gotta be kidding me.
Directing traffic. William Regal is sending a message. you have to believe that there's going to be some serious repercussions for William Regal's actions here tonight.